Hello, this is Billy Corr from the Nostalgia Mall, and welcome to the first episode of a new series I'm going to try out called Nostalgia Mall Quickies. Basically, these are going to be videos that are just really short, straight to the point about stuff that I really don't have enough material to make a full-fledged video about. And this right here is a perfect example of that type of video. I picked this up this afternoon at Goodwill in Winston-Salem today. This is a Microsoft Sidewinder gamepad with its original box. If I had to guess, probably it's from sometime around 1998 or so. Would have been cool to have gotten the Sidewinder joystick, but hey, this will do just fine, and it will look good in my vintage software collection, even though this is technically hardware. And of course, as you can possibly see, this has been opened before. Cost me $15 at Goodwill. I definitely overpaid, but I figured, why not pick it up, make a quick video about it. And again, it would look good on my shelf. So, we're not going to hook it up or anything. I just want to show the box and what lies within the box. This is still showing its $10 rebate sticker. Expires January 1st, 2000. So we're definitely expired on that. Perfect for sports, fighting, and arcade-style games. Full function with up to four Sidewinder gamepads connected and program multi-button game moves to one button. I never had one of these as a kid. I always played with joysticks. That sounded very inappropriate. And there goes the monetization. So anyway, I only used joysticks on computers back then. I saved the gamepads for the consoles, but I do recall getting some type of gamepad, I think a USB one, for our Toshiba Satellite 2505 CDS back in the day. So, I did eventually get one, but for most of the time, I was using joysticks. But, I am still glad to have this. Here's the, left side. That might be the original, seal right there, but it is aftermarketly taped together. And it's, designed for Windows 95. Has a CD-ROM, hopefully it's still in there. Works only with Windows 95 base games and MS-DOS base games that run within Windows 95. I know what that's talking about. You see these newer Sidewinder gamepads and joysticks from the late 90s or so? Even though they use the game port, they do not work in real DOS mode. They work if you play a game within a DOS game within Windows, but if you want to play a DOS game in actual DOS, you're going to be out of luck. And that's unfortunate, but oh well. No big deal, I guess. Again, there's the left side. Right side, more of the same. And the back of the box. More buttons, more functions, more control. There's no other controller like the Microsoft Sidewinder gamepad. Why am I reading this? You can just pause the video and read there. Okay, you done pausing? Okay, we can move on. Okay. 8-way direction pad, mode button, start button. I think I do have a gamepad somewhere in storage, just like this one, but it's a little bit low end compared to this one. This one has some more functions on it, I do believe. And a little teaser for the Sidewinder Precision Pro. And we can go within our, look at our system requirements. You need at least a 486, Windows 95, 8 megs of RAM, 12 megs of hard drive space, and other good stuff. And it says copyright 1997. So I was pretty close on the date there. So let's crack it open. Hopefully we still have some goodies inside. I do know the gamepad's in there. So I hope there is enough stuff in here for this video to be worth our while. So, gotta cut through this tape there. Yeah, I think I do see the CD-ROM in there. So we got that at least. Here's our gamepad. Again, this is used, but it looks to be in very good condition, though. There we go. And there's all the technical doodad stuff there on the back. And if we pull this off, I don't know how to do it. I've never done this before. You can daisy chain other game port controllers for multiplayer, which is really nice. Never had a chance to do that as a kid because I was a very, very lonely child with no friends. But that will bring the video down if I continue on that. So, okay, that's back in place. There's our gamepad. Now, any other goodies held within? Some empty plastic that's probably housed the gamepad itself at one point. Okay, I'm adding this in afterwards. I forgot to show the registration card that was in the box. Don't forget, if you've registered online, you do not need to send this registration card. Thank you for the information there. If you live in the United States, send it to Illinois. If you live in Canada, send it to San Francisco, which is not in Canada, which is kind of bizarre. And on the back is where you fill out all the good stuff there. And this one dates from 1998, I believe. Discover a world of possibilities on the Microsoft World Wide website. You don't hear the term World Wide Web much these days anymore. So, anyway, on with the rest of the show. I do see a CD in here. Here we go. Now, this is nice to have. Sidewinder Gamepad. Sidewinder game device software includes profiler, activator, editor, and drivers. I have used this before, or software similar to this from Microsoft, but I've downloaded it from various websites over the years. I've never had the official CD before. And all the stuff on the back. And in typical Microsoft fashion, if you do not agree with the license agreement, you have to take it back and get a refund. I always thought that was kind of odd, but makes sense. And open it up. Guess we got a manual there we can look at real quick. Important ergonomic information. You got to prevent getting that carpal tunnel. Software setup instructions. Presumably, this should work just fine on Windows 98 as well. This would have come out during the era of 95. It was if it came out in 1997. I'm talking nonsense now, I do believe. Okay, now we got to get this back in here. And the CD, let's see if there's. Feels like it's never been used, actually. Yeah, it looks brand new. Very, very nice. And I actually do have a use for this gamepad. Actually, you know what? Since I got a gamepad just like this somewhere in storage, I think I'll keep this in the box just for preservation. I'll probably use it at some point. I'll make an image of the CD, and I plan to use it on my Ultimate Packard Bell 3550, which we saw in this week's video. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed the first episode of Nostalgia Mall Quickies. These will be uploaded from time to time when I get the inspiration to just make a quick video about something random like this, such as this gamepad, which is really cool to have. So, till next time, this is Billy Corr, signing off. Thank you for visiting the Nostalgia Mall. If you liked what you saw, please like, subscribe, and follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You can also support me on Patreon if you would like. The link to all of these are down below. Until next time, this is Billy Corr, signing off.